Any questions?
Before I start talking about anything, just wanted to know how many of you have heard or know about crowdsourcing in software testing as a concept? Any of you who have used or participated as a tester? So there is knowledge there. I'm just thinking about 10 years, are thinking about it, taking very seriously. Okay. So just a little bit about the company that I work for. The company name is Pass Group. We are a Swiss-based company. So we've been doing managed crowdsourced software testing for more than 3 years now. We've been working with some of the large companies across the globe in crowdsourcing. In India, we are operating from Bangalore and Mumbai, and we've been delivering services to a lot of Indian players in crowdsourcing and a lot of other global players in the US and European market. So before I start with the discussion, I'll just brief you about how I have structured this session for today. We'll be first talking about how the IT evolution is leading to changing demands or changing needs in the business environment, and how that is leading to a concept called crowdsourcing becoming more and more important as we go forward into more futuristic and more advanced level of software quality. Then we'll talk about crowdsourcing, crowd testing as a concept, give you an overview, talk about its application, also its approach in a very, very basic way. And then we'll build on top of it, talking a little bit more as an enterprise, what needs to be done to produce a managed crowd testing solution, so which is like more professional and more enterprise level crowd testing solution. Then we will talk about some of the perceived concerns and their mitigations, because there are a lot of issues like IP, accountability, when you talk about crowdsourcing. So how those are handled in an enterprise world. We'll talk about some of the critical success factors. And finally, we'll look at a few case studies from the real world. This is something which is, I think, known to all of us, that the of mobile, cloud, and advent of web-based solutions. So over a period of time, what we are seeing is that there is a lot of consumerization within the enterprise world as well. So if you look at a lot of organizations, they're talking about, just a session before that, talking about gamification in an enterprise world. I mean, that is totally consumerization of your staff and consumerization of how you interact with your customers. So providing mobile-based CRM solutions, mobile-based ERP solutions. So all these things are becoming more and more prominent. And that is one reason why it is creating a lot of complexity in our IT landscape, per se. So the app number of apps are going beyond 25 billion is the app size market, and this is supposed to be shooting up much, much faster in the next 5 to 6 years. The whole organization infrastructure, platforms, everything is moving on the cloud. So platform as a service, infrastructure as a service, software as a service, these are like not just a buzzword anymore. I mean, 3 years back we were all talking about it. Now actually the companies are implementing all of it. And what it is leading to is, it is leading to an organization becoming a consumer. So that means that things like open source, which were supposed to be a taboo just about 4 or 5 years back, are something that every organization is now implementing. So I think all of you would be knowing about Selenium, which is becoming more and more prominent as an automation tool nowadays, right? I mean, replacing UTPs and other automation tools. And this is giving an independence to people or staff who are working or yourselves in the organization to take a decision what you want to use in your organization as a tool. And these days it is not so rigid that an IT enterprise will say, no, you cannot use this because it's an open source. A lot of companies are being very, very open about usage of social media, usage of these premium kind of solutions. So Skype, a lot of organizations are using Skype to communicate within their staff. So with all these things coming in, it is becoming more and more challenging for us as a QA organizations, as a QA industry, to provide high quality results at an optimum cost and an optimum speed. Because you are creating so many different permutations and combinations because of so many different platforms of hardware and software on which every software application is getting deployed. And so, I mean, just a session was there in the morning when a person was very provocatively talking about coding is so necessary and without coding you cannot live with. I mean, every tester has to be a coder. I would say every tester has to be a user. He should not be a coder. Because in the end, the application is to be used by someone, right? If you don't have the perspective of a user, what is the use? No matter how intelligent or smart you are as a coder, you will not understand the feature or the purpose of that application. You will understand the function of that application. You will not understand the purpose of that application. So please try to understand the function. And that is where you have to bring in a user perspective when you're testing. And that user perspective comes through a concept, something like a crowdsourcing, where you bring in more and more different kind of people to come and work for you and give a feedback on the software in terms of quality and usability. The same thing, there are a lot of use case scenarios that are coming up which cannot be tested within the the purview of the requirements anymore. That's why exploratory testing is something that is picking up again. I mean, in the beginning it started from exploratory testing. I remember in early 2000s, everybody was saying that we have done free testing and it's good enough. Then we said, no, we have to do, I mean, as an organization we go and sell. No, you have to do more planned testing. It has to be test case based and other. And now what we're doing is we are seeing the whole circle. Now we are saying, okay, planned testing, yes, but on top of that, you need to do a little bit of exploratory. Because no matter how far a business person can think, still it is not where an end user is thinking. So there may be certain scenarios which might have not been documented in the requirement itself, which a user might need. So you have a requirement bias. You are a tester within an organization. Based on your requirement documents, you're doing the test. So that is where the user perspective or an outsider's perspective comes into play. So just, I think all of you are testers which are part of a traditional testing method. And I would say all of you are testers who could be a crowdsourced tester also. So no offense to how it is, but generally this is how it works. I mean, there are people who have been working on the same projects for years. And it is it's like a holy Diwali. Every November there is a release, so we have to start preparing for the release. We have to do our system test, system integration test, run those test cases, deploy it, right? And that becomes like a tradition, a rule. So what I think just before this, my friend from Amazon was talking about, he was saying that you can gamify regression testing, right? That's a very good idea because you are bringing in some interesting feature out. Otherwise, things become very, very mundane, and that's when the defects start leaking. Because your task is just to finish off a regression suit. Because even if you finish it off, your boss is not going to be very happy. He would say that, yes, this was something that needs to be done. You took 3 days, it should have been done in 2 days. Right? So that's how the mindset works in regression testing. It's something that needs to be done, and neither the customer nor your own management is very keen about completing the regression testing and those kind of aspects. Right? So generally, how a traditional method works is, you put in people, they're doing their work, they're getting paid, so it's a very, very mundane and it could lead to some kind of dull environment. Now, I'm just trying to introduce crowd testing here, but before I introduce it, just want to hear out from some of you guys who have worked as a tester or some of you who have actually, have an understanding of crowd testing. What do you understand by crowd testing as a concept? Can someone give me a definition without reading? Obviously, you'll read it then.
So that could be a kind of a crowdsourcing,
beta
releases.
That's one aspect of crowd testing and one of the prominent aspects of crowd testing.
I know about the crowd testing, crowdsourcing.
Yeah.
But I feel, is it like, okay, like bringing people with different mindset from different background, different culture, so that they work differently, so they can
So you are taking one step ahead, exactly next to what he's saying. So, see, beta testing is something that now a lot of firms have been doing, not just now, they've been doing for very, very long. What we are trying to bring through crowd testing is bringing that beta phase a little early into the life cycle. Right? You can introduce this at any point in time. You can introduce it as a system testing phase, system integration testing phase, and plus in the beta phase as well.